to have a really solid stay. And they need it on the contacts, they need it on the table, they need it on the start line. So I want you to notice in life, real life outside of agility, if there are times when you're asking your dog to sit or down that you may not always be formally releasing them. A classic one is you're getting stuff out of the car or whatever, you say sit, and you're done getting your stuff and you're ready to go in the apartment and you don't care that the dog is coming with you because you were ready for him to come with you.
Yeah.
I want you to notice if you're doing that because it's a kiss of death and you can't live there. Because the release word is what really gets mixed up for the dogs. If they don't know when to go, you don't have a stay. If they don't know when the stay is over, you don't have one. One of the easiest ways to ruin a stay and to get a wire really crossed in a dog's brain is to tell them sit and then release them simultaneously with movement. You could stack, I'm very, very broke, and you could put a stack of $1,000 bills on that table, and I wouldn't do it with my young dog. So it's okay if you're running and you release, and it's okay if you're holding still when you release, but you don't want to go. Because if you were teaching a drop on recall, the way you would teach it is you would say, down, down, and you'd pay and release, you do it again, down, pay and release, down, and you do that about 6 times until the 7th time you would do that and not say down, and that's how you would teach a hand signal, by doing a movement simultaneously with the verbal that the dog already knows. So classic agility is when you front cross and release simultaneously. So you're going, okay, the dogs will learn that the front cross when they're on the contact is a release. And you really have to proof that to say, you always got to wait for what I say. So when I set these drills up, you guys, if I'm working lead outs, I'm working lead outs. The dog is on the stay over there, and I have led out. If I'm not doing a lead out, I'm doing something like this, I'm just going to have my hand in the dog's collar, revving him up now. Because I haven't said sit, so I'm not messing nothing up. And I have to move simultaneously with the dog. I don't have any other options. Does that make sense? I'm just omitting the sit, or the down, or the positional cue. Okay? So if I'm going to work on my lead out, I work on my lead out. You follow me?
Sure.
So I would not say sit. Okay, go. I would either lead out, meaning I would be on the other side of the obstacle, or I would just run with the dog and not even bother with a sit. I'm either doing a lead out or not. Yeah?
What about using your jump cue versus your release cue? So, for example,
but you would have to move. It doesn't matter what the word is. The word could be ice cream. And if the dog is hearing it while you're moving, it's going to become your release word. And I don't want to release. You guys, there comes a point in the dog's career where I will release off a contact on a directional. Like if they're on the A-frame and I need to turn them into the tunnel. your life to make sure you're really being consistent with releasing them from their any state position. And then you guys know this is a wild beginners, right?
Huh?
Wild beginners coming in.